First thing we do in Marbella is find a Lidl. Oh yes, people. Oh my God, can I just stay here forever? I haven't sunbathed like this for a good 2 years. Max is in the pool. I'm not allowed to go in the pool because my tan. So it'll go green. But I'm not that bothered. I like chilling hair. Oh, this is so nice. So nice. Cold? Freezing. So yeah, I'm just gonna update you guys. We went shopping. Food. We went to Lidl's. We found a Lidl's, which is like brilliant. It's like a 20-minute walk from our hotel. So we got loads of chicken and stuff like that for me to have throughout the day. Stuff for me to have for a comp and stuff as well. But yeah, that's pretty much what we've done. And today we'll just have a chill day. We'll just have a nice relaxing day because I haven't actually had a day like this or like spent any time like this on holiday for like legit 2 years. So but yeah, we're just gonna have a nice relaxed day, and then tonight my coach is flying in with one of my teammates, and then we'll go meet them, and then tomorrow we're registering for the competition. So I'll show you obviously what we get up to there. Registrations from like this competition as well, guys, is like international level. Like it's a very big show. And I'm so excited to do it. Like, I'm so honoured to do it. Like, I had a look at the running order, and I'm against people that I follow on Instagram and aspire to be like one day. So it's like absolutely mental. And I don't think I'll get anywhere from this. I just want to experience my first international show because I felt good over the weekend. Like, I felt really good winning, obviously, all three categories that I did. So I thought, fuck it, why not? Why not do another one? Like, I got invited to it, and this hotel was quite cheap. The flights were all right, like, price. So I thought, why not? Kind of, I kept on thinking, like, if I didn't go, I would regret it, and I know I would. So I was like, I need to go, and I need to do it for me. So that's what I've done. And so far, I'm having an amazing time. Like, even though the competition's on Saturday, like, just chilling and actually just spending time with Max is like even that's nice. So yes, I'm gonna stop rambling now and relax, and I'll probably see you tomorrow at registration. So see you guys then. I'm so tired. I got a little room, a little balcony, looking out. It's beautiful, it really is. Really, really tired today. Just finished registration, because you have to register the day before you compete, which today is Friday today. And registrations open from 10 till 8 in the evening. There's over 400 athletes, and everything has to be registered and done by 8 o'clock. So I'm all registered, and I got my international IFBB passport. Like, I was so excited when I was getting it done, because obviously, because I won and came overall, that's what they pay for, and they pay for registration. So that's about a good 500 euros or so, which is really, like, I was honoured. I was so happy that they paid for it, because I was like, otherwise I wouldn't have obviously been able to come. But I've just been sleeping. It's like half four now, I think. I was absolutely like, I was so knackered all day. I've been sitting in the sun, and I've just been so tired. Like, I just had to have a rest, and I feel a lot better now because I've been walking around a little bit today, and I was just like, I need to go to bed. I need to have a little bit of a nap because I don't want to be tired for tomorrow, anything like that. So, yeah, but yeah, I feel good now. I feel better. Still feel a bit like bloated. And stuff, but I'm gonna go and see coach and see what he says because he's come down with us. He came yesterday, so yeah, I'm tired. I've just been sleeping for like an hour, and water stopped, so I have no more water until tomorrow now. And now all I want is water, but I need to have a few more rice cakes and stuff. Just chilling, really. Have some rice cakes. But yeah, I had a really good day today. Just relaxed and like chilled out. But yeah, I'm excited. I'm so excited. It's like surreal that I'm still here. I just can't believe it. I'm like, what the hell? And there's like girls that I'm gonna be sharing the stage with that I've like looked up to for like since the beginning of my journey, and I'm just I'm just like excited to be on stage with them. I'm like, I'm a big fan of you. I'm gonna be like fangirling tomorrow. Big time. But, oh well. Okay, so I'll see you tomorrow. I will see you then. Turn right now. It's really, really dark. I am a bit worried because it's very dark. But it's fine. We're gonna not worry about it. These are my marks from the English Grand Prix where my bikini was and like scratching me to death. So, but I look a lot darker than I thought I would. But it's fine. I do feel bloated this morning. I've just had breakfast, to be fair, so like, no wonder I'm a little bit bloated. But when I get a bit bloated like this, I just get nervous and I get worried that I'm not gonna look good on stage and blah, blah, blah. Everything runs through my mind and I'm just like, but we're gonna carry on. We're gonna go get my makeup done in like 15 minutes. I don't know what time I'm gonna be on. I'm gonna be probably on in the evening. Which another thing I'm worried about because I need to hold my condition all day and it's like 9:30 right now. But it's fine, we're gonna carry on. And I need to remember that this is all about experience. It's not about placing at this one. I never thought I would place at this one because this is like next level competing. Like I'm competing against girls that I've absolutely adored from like the very start. And I'm honored to be like on stage with them. So I'm not thinking about placings right now. I just want to bring my best to the stage, and that's what I'm worried about. So I'm gonna go get my makeup done, and that's another thing, my armpits, they're not tanning and I don't know why, but it's fine, I'm gonna carry on. But yeah, I'm gonna go get my makeup done and I'm gonna show you where we get it done. Is it good?
And they love it. Okay, just look down here. And then look that way.
Thank you so much. Makeup and hair all done. I am stress-free today, so I'm very happy about that. But they washed my hair. He told me my hair was too greasy, so he needed to wash it. So I was like, thank you so much for that. But I'm just gonna go pack up my whole life because we're leaving today. So I have to literally pack up all my stuff in the next like half an hour because I'm late right now back to the hotel. So I will see you then. So we are literally backstage now and look how big backstage is. It's a massive hall, like huge. I was with my friend like not too long ago, but I've just like, I don't know where she's gone from. I'm just chilling now, but makeup's all done, tan's done. Max just needs to glaze me with oil and then I'm done. I think I'm gonna be on like an hour and a half. There's 12 in my category. I'm 126. But yeah, I'm just happy. I'm just so happy to be here. Like, I don't even care about anything else. Like, I'm just happy to be here. So, like, no matter what the placing is today, I know I've worked fucking hard. This week has been really hard. Like, really hard. So, I've done well. So, yeah, I'm happy. I just wanna get on stage, do my thing, and then go eat a shit ton of food. There's a pizza parlor right next to the stadium, and that is what I'm getting, with like calamari, pasta, loads of cheese. So, but yeah, I'm gonna relax now, and I will see you after I get on stage. See you later.
One, two, six.
Let's go, Phoebe!
Thank you very much, ladies. Now we're going to the stage and do the final of the top six. Excellent. I think we're in a super cool class with the videos. Number one, three, and two. And the top six will be up for the final for the individual presentation. Sport Paran.
Woo! Let's go, Phoebe! To the front!
Thank you very much for the final is ready with Germany, Czech Republic, Romania, United Kingdom, Russia, and United Kingdom as well. Ladies?
Let's go, Phoebe!
Ladies, go to 30, all right?
Great!
You step forward.
Come on, baby!
walk to the front.
Let's go, Phoebe!
Phoebe, how do you like the pizza?
Top notch.
Is it the best pizza ever?
Yes.
After coming sick at the amateur Olympia.
First European show, international show.
Please ignore the way I look right now. I'm currently in bed. It's like 7:30. It's Monday. So 2 days later since I have competed. And I'm in total shock. Like, I seem to I don't even know. Like, I am so thankful and I just can't believe it. Like, I just don't even know what to say. Like, wow. This weekend has, like, a little... this weekend has been absolutely amazing. I'm so happy that I decided to go, because at first I wasn't gonna go because I kind of didn't want to go, because obviously if Max wasn't going, I didn't want to go by myself and kind of do it by my on my own, so I kind of was like, I'm not gonna go, but last minute decision, we kind of sorted everything out, we booked flights really cheap, and then because I won all three categories at the English Grand Prix, they paid for my registration and my international passport, members passport, because that's what you need to compete abroad in UKBFF. So they paid for that and registration, which is probably the most priciest part, which is really, really good. I'm still in shock that I went, and I'm back now, and it feels like ages ago now. I'm just looking at all I've got 4 trophies and 2 medals over there, and I'm wow, what a bloody weekend. It's crazy, but it was really, really good. I wasn't 100% happy with my physique that I went on with, and I know that I wasn't my leanest, but I am my own worst critic, but I know even my coach said I wasn't my leanest, I know that, I could have been leaner, but it was definitely the heat and like kind of a bit stressed because I was stressing a little bit like the day before and the day of. So I could have been holding water from that. And possibly the flight, but I could have been leaner. But this is just me being like really critical with every single like detail, because I'll insert photos here, but like, I was really happy with the photos that like I got from stage, and I did really like my physique that I went on with, but it's just like in my own head, like things that I can work on. And another thing was, because over like bikini is like your over, like it's an overall appearance, you need to kind of have everything, like you need to have the body, the hair, the makeup, like everything. My hair literally out of nowhere was like just like, my hair is obviously naturally curly and I straighten it because I really like it straight. And it literally just went massive from the heat, like absolutely huge. And that was another thing on stage. It was just so big and like, just, I don't know, it just wasn't right. And I knew that. And that was one of the things the judges kind of could have said you could have worked on, was like hair and stuff. But apart from that, the feedback was I was really confident on stage. Like I looked really comfortable. And my coach said that he was like, against those girls, you look like you did hold your own, and that's what I wanted to do. Like I wanted to at least show people that I could hold my own on stage, and like I'm happy I did. I'm really happy I did. And I was one point. Max is like, that's not something you should be shouting about, but like that was a close call. I was one point away from being seventh, which, like, wow, that's very close to not getting placed. And then when I did my IWOC, which was like the individual walk, I brought it back and I earned myself like more points on that, because I was like, I felt more confident. Obviously I said that I didn't want a place, and I didn't, like, I didn't expect a place at the show at all. Like I didn't think like anything that I would place at all. I came sixth, by the way. So I came top six. So they gave trophies to top six and I came sixth, which I was really happy with. And my friend Effie, she got fifth, which I was literally, I cannot believe. Like, she did so well and she looked amazing. And I'm so happy for her. She literally did so well. But I didn't expect a place. But as a competitor, like, in the back of my mind, like, probably that minuscule tiny little bit at the back of my mind, I was like, it would be cool to place. Like, it would be so cool to place at my first international show. But I didn't expect it, because like I said before, if you expect it, you'll be disappointed. And even if I didn't place, I wouldn't be disappointed, because I was so happy with the way I went on stage and the way I was confident on stage. So already I was a winner because I'd hit my goals of what I wanted to do. But in the back of my mind, as a competitor, you always kind of want to place like a little, like, if you're kind of doing it for fun, which is totally fair enough, you can, that's fine. But like a tiny little bit in the back of my mind, I was like, it would be really cool to place top six. I didn't get first call outs. I got second call outs. Because there was 12 in my category and they cut it down to six. But they first brought out top five, they didn't bring out top six, so that's when I was like, oh, I haven't placed, like, that's fine, like, I'm all right with that. And then they called my name backstage and they were like, oh yeah, 126, and I was like, excuse me? Me? And yeah, that was when I was literally like, wow, like, so, so honoured. And all of the girls that were on stage, I all follow on Instagram, I all, like, all of them, I was like, I'm so honoured to be in your presence right now. Like, just crazy. And yeah, I'm just so honoured. And plan of action now is just to keep getting better. And I've got that fire in my stomach now where I just want to keep going and going. Like, I've got now got invites for Arnold, Barcelona. I've got the British to do, the UKBFF British finals to do. And I've got the, I don't know what it's called, I think it's the IFBB Diamond Cup in Finland and the IFBB Diamond Cup in Liverpool. So I've got four more competitions to do. I don't know whether I'm going to do four competitions or three. I'm definitely going to either do four or three. I'm not going to do two or one. Just because I feel like I can do it this time, I'm in a better position. Because I did seven shows last year and that was hard. But I think I can do it this year. Six shows, why not? but yeah, plan of action now. It is Monday today, isn't it? And I leave to go travelling with my sister for 2 weeks on Wednesday. So I'm all over the place right now. I'm going to Amsterdam, Budapest, Croatia, Prague and Berlin. So if anyone has any recommendations, please comment down below because I'd love to know any recommendations. And then, yeah, after that is I'll get back the 1st of July and then I'm going to do another 10-week cut for Arnold's Barcelona. And my goals for Arnold's Barcelona is to place. Because I've now got the recognition internationally, I would absolutely love to place. So I'm going to bring my absolute best condition yet. So I'm obviously going to have time off. I'm going to still track macros, obviously, when I am travelling. Just because I don't want to obviously gain unnecessary fat whilst I'm away, because you can do that in 2 weeks. And I can, obviously I will enjoy myself, but I will track what I'm having because I don't want to just swerve in the wrong direction. It'd be so harder to get back on it when I get back for the Arnold's. So, that being said, that's my plan. That's my plan of action. I do want to place at the Arnold's because placing at the Arnold's would mean a lot to me, and I'd just love to get that recognition internationally because my goal overall with competing is to get my pro card, my IFBB pro card to become an IFBB pro. So yeah, I've rambled for about 10 minutes now. I was going to do a quick 5-minute update, but I've now rambled for 10. But thank you so much for watching my vlog. I've had so much love on my show day vlog already. So if you haven't watched it already, please go watch it. But thank you so much for all the support recently, guys. Like, you've been absolutely amazing. Like, thank you so much. Please like and subscribe to my channel because it really supports my channel and gets me out there more and reaches more people to help more people and to inspire more people. So, that being said, love you so much. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.